There are two aspects to this. First of all, you need to understand why do you need to do employer branding. First, set your goals right, set your objective right, and once you do that, then you move on to define the matrix. One objective could be that you want to be different than your competitors. You don't want to be repetitive like they were. What is it that you are doing in the market or for your employees? So perhaps your employee value proposition is completely different than what your competitors are doing. That could be one aspect of it. The other thing is that whether you want to retain people or you want to attract better talent, that could be another objective. So define your objective clearly. And then you move down to matrix. Now, what are the different matrix that you follow or you understand before you actually define whether your employer branding is doing a good job or not? One is your cost per hire. You will realize that your cost per hire will reduce because you will start getting good talent. So the conversion ratios from the time you line up candidates, like suppose earlier your conversion ratios could be every 50 employees lined up, only one gets selected. If now you feel that your conversion ratio reduces down to around 50%, that's another parameter for you to judge that your employer branding is doing a good job. Now, from a market perspective, if your cost per hire reduces by around 12%, then that's a very good way. That's a very good way to assess that you had been doing a good job. So that is one. Another one is that how many people you are attracting. You know, earlier, perhaps your applicant ratio was very limited, like 50 people. Now you suddenly see there is a surge of CVs which are coming to you. Why? Because you have a brand created in the market. So that could be the second one. The third could be that the offer acceptance ratio. If you had an offer decline ratio, which was much higher earlier, completely reduces down. That would also tell you that your employee value proposition or your employer branding has become better. Another way could be that your employee referrals become stronger. You know, you suddenly see that employee referral percentages has increased and the people are actually referring more people like their friends or their family because they feel there is something that the organization is giving them and they would like them to work along with them. So that means your net promoter score has gone up. So that could be one other aspect of it. And I think you will start realizing that your source of hire is very different. Earlier, perhaps you have to contact different consultants and go out in the market talking to them and saying that, okay, this is what we have to do. This is what the organization is doing. And now you suddenly feel that through various social media networks, different applicants, different candidates are getting in touch with you. Perhaps it's LinkedIn, perhaps when you post a job in Naukri, there are more applications to it. So you will see that the source of hiring changes dramatically after a good employer branding exercise. So those are some of the aspects you would look at. And one more aspect that perhaps I should add here is the retention of your employees. You would see that suddenly when you are giving that value proposition to your employees, they understand what is internally that you are providing them. You will see that your attrition percentages go down. You might feel that everyone talks about salary to a very large extent. Everyone feels that they are not paid well. That is only one aspect to employee satisfaction or how is it that they want to stay with the organization. There are things more than just money, you know. There are a lot of other things that you give as an organization to your employees. There could be job rotations. There could be a different aspect to the career. Perhaps someone wants to move from marketing to sales. You know, if that as an organization, are you giving them that thing? Another could be on-site opportunities that you give as an organization. So there are different aspects. And how well do you go out and communicate back to your employees? It's very, very important. You let them know that this is what we tend to give you. This is what we feel that is as an organization. We feel you deserve as an employee. You will understand that they will stay back with you. And that's another parameter to understand and know that your employer branding is doing a good job.